How to use patterns with Rebelle. By default, Rebelle doesn't come with patterns, but there is a tiling feature and you can find it via the stencils. So window menu and stencils. Now layers could be useful as well. You can create layers which you can add your designs to, but stencils is the key one for this tutorial. So once you've got the stencils panel, and I'm just going to quickly bring that over. See, there's a whole range of different stencils already available. What you can do, you can go to the right side menu and there's an option there, create stencil from image file. What that does, it will browse for an image file. Now, I'm not certain of all the formats that it can use. I generally use PNG format for all my pattern designs. But of course, you could use any image as a pattern. It doesn't have to be seamless tiled. So I've got some patterns here. These ones are graphic extra patterns that I created and they're all seamless tiles. But as I said, you can use any file as your design. As long as it's like PNG, probably JPEG, etc., it should be supported. So once you've selected a file, simply open it. I'm going to go with one of them. So you can see once you've done that, it will be added to the stencils panel. And you can see quite a few other stencil files I've created earlier, as well as ones that come by default with Rebelle. So simply select that and drag into the document, the image file. Put it about the center, up to you. You can reposition it again. Sometimes if you put it in the wrong place, you end up with this right at the top. You may want to reposition that. So if you can't see that panel, it's really tricky. So probably the best way is just to undo it and then re-add the stencil in the center. What you can do, you can move the stencil. You can also resize the stencil. You can also rotate the stencil. There's also a little menu in the fourth section there. And there's tile option. And that's the pattern feature, tile. So it just tiles it. And you can see now, because the design was a seamless design, you can see a tile, a pattern. And I can resize that, rescale it. So you can see even more clearly that there's a thing. And a great feature, you can also rotate it as well as, of course, reposition it. And again, you can see the seamless tiles still there. And of course, once you've got your stencil, what you can do with your stencil, you can use it to paint with. And of course, you could do this on layers. Now, I'm just using a single layer, but you could create multiple layers and then combine them in different ways with maybe different patterns. So I'm going to select one of the paintbrushes, doesn't particularly matter which one, and simply apply the current color. You can apply it now with that stencil in place. And what happens is you've got the color, obviously, on the paper, the stencil is blocking the rest of the paint, which is really great. So you can create and add a pattern. Now, it's not obviously a pattern. If you've got a very colourful pattern design, this is only going to be a very basic pattern design, but it's still a pattern design you can add using these brushstrokes. Now, I'd love to see a true pattern feature added to this, but this is a workaround. And of course, you can add any brushstroke and you can change it. And of course, you can go and change the stencil. You don't have to keep the same stencil. You can, of course, resize the stencil. You can rotate the stencil again and add. So you can create some interesting effects simply by resizing it. And again, like I said, this could be done on different layers as well. And then you, of course, could move the layers. And you can continue to apply your brushstrokes. Now, one thing you probably best do is go to the layers panel and dry the current layer. You're using, so I would suggest, as soon as you do that, just go and dry it. Once you've finished working with a particular stencil, go and dry it. Unless you want the paint to drift downwards and, in a sense, ruin the pattern. So if I add these brushstrokes, what I can do, I can now remove the stencil, which is fine, But suddenly, as soon as you do that, you'll see the pattern suddenly becomes a little bit more smudgy, a little bit, as it obviously blurs into the paper. You may or may not want that. It's a perfectly reasonable effect. It's one of the great features of Rebelle, the way it smears and blurs into the paper. So I would suggest dry it as soon as, at any point. You can dry it at any time. You don't have to wait until you remove the stencil, of course. So you can go now. So I'm just going to go down the bottom. Remove. And now as soon as you do that, that pattern will start to deteriorate in terms of it sort of suddenly isn't so much of a pattern anymore, as it all starts to fall down the page or blend into the page. I'm just going to completely remove that. I'm going to undo that work. And the key thing, I say, is to go over to the layers panel and click the dry. Now, once you come out of the stencil, it won't suddenly drift down. If you want the complete pattern to be preserved as a pattern. What you can also do in this, I can remove now. And you say now, it doesn't lose its crispness. So you've got a lovely pattern design there, which of course you can then work on, move and apply effects to, etc. But you can of course do more than that with these stencils. So I'm just going to show you, you can invert the stencil as well. And that can be used to create some interesting effects as well. And of course, you can still continue to move it, rotate it, and so on and so on. And of course, you can scale it down to, I'm not certain what the limit is. So you can make it very, very, very small. I'm certain there is a limit. And of course, you can increase it. But as it's a pixel design, obviously, if you extend, really scale it upwards, you'll probably find that it will not look so great. Well, like I say, you can invert in the same menu that on that corner menu. And then you can, of course, apply your paint, watercolors, etc. to the stencil now that's been inverted. So you can apply that. And what you can do, you can always then invert again and go back and apply maybe a different colour to the stencil again. And you don't have to use the same stencil. Of course, you've got a whole range of different stencils there. You can drag a different stencil and work with that as well. So you can create some very interesting, colourful pattern designs. Again, sadly, it's not a true pattern feature in that you can bring in, import a lovely, colourful pattern and then maybe use that to work with in Rebelle. But again, always, once you're working with things, you can always simply go over to the dry option and dry your paint. And it probably works best when you're using pattern tiles. Just to quickly dry it. Again, you can rotate it, you can scale it, you can move it, and again, you can go and invert it via that little box menu there. Now it's quite small. Sometimes it's off the screen. So sometimes I have to bring it. So you can go back to the default setting there. And of course, what you can do, you can then apply paint to the stencil again. And of course, I haven't repositioned it now, so it's just going on top. So you can just, of course, the red and all that sort of stuff not being modified. Again, you can dry it. Go and select a different colour. Apply it again. I'm doing this very rough. Obviously, you could take a lot of care. Maybe you could go around, create very thin lines with your design. Maybe use a sort of hatchwork, whatever. Obviously, I'm just like, say, roughly applying it to show you as an example. But there's obviously all the other pen tools, pencils, etc., can be used with these stencils as well and be used with the patterns. And again, dry it again. Once you're happy with everything, you want to see your pattern, simply just remove it. Let's go down the bottom and remove. And then you've got your pattern design there. Very quick and easy. Done using stencils. And you've got a whole range of different stencils there. And so there's options. You can use selections. You can use the current image as well as a potential pattern tile. And it's all via that option from image file. And of course, you can use, like, say, PNG files, etc. And you can create all kinds of wonderful pattern designs, which you can then import and use as patterns in Rebelle. Hope you found this tutorial of interest. Always adding new tutorials about Photoshop, Rebelle, Finity Photo, Finity Designer, and many others. Please subscribe to the Graphic Extras channel. Also, please add some comments. Always appreciated. A dislike or like. Thank you much.